For many years, major diseases in aquaculture were controlled by using antibiotics. Although these substances could eliminate the microflora of intestines and enhance utilization of amino acid by the host, the usage of antibiotics possess more harmful effect to the environment as well as the animal in the lower food chain to the highest, including human. As an alternative, feed additives were introduced, including immunostimulant, to replace antibiotics against disease outbreak. Immunostimulants are substances suitable to be used in aquaculture feed to enhance disease resistance against pathogenic disease by enhancing innate immune response. What is innate immune response? Innate immune response is the first line of defense with non-specific antigens. The defense mechanism will respond immediately upon infection because the components on innate immune response are always available in the body. This is in contrast with specific or adaptive immunity, which require long time between exposure of pathogens and maximal response as the body uses this time to generate antibodies specific for the infecting antigen. So, innate immune response is the fundamental defense mechanism of fish. And immunostimulants are the substances that could enhance the innate immunity response in fish. It is non-pathogenic, non-toxic, and do not produce undesirable effect towards the aquatic organisms. Several dietary additives from chemical agents, polysaccharides, animal and plant extracts have been identified to be effective immunostimulants and successfully improve resistance to non-specific pathogens. Immunostimulants can be administered by injection, bathing, or orally, with the latter appearing to be the most practical. One of the promising immunostimulants is beta-glucan, which is a naturally occurring polysaccharide found in the cell wall of various plants. With oat, mushrooms, baker yeast, seaweeds, and certain types of fungi. Over the past 2 decades, the use of beta-glucan has been thoroughly investigated as feed supplements in many aquaculture species. Great survival rates were observed over fish fed with beta-glucan when challenged against wide varieties of pathogenic bacteria, including Vibrio, Aeromonas, and Edwardsiella. Another common immunostimulants in aquaculture were extracted from herbs and plant materials. Several plants were identified to contain medicinal values such as mistletoe, nettle, ginger, and Chinese medicinal herb. Based on these studies of this plant's extract, enhanced immune response were reported in many important aquaculture species. For example, rainbow trout fed with mistletoe, nettle, and ginger extract showed enhanced non-specific immune response. NILE fed with astragalus membranous increased phagocytic activity within 1 week after supplementation. Besides, higher survival rates were also observed in CARP fed with astragalus membranous following a challenge with Aeromonas hydrophila bacteria. Chitin and chitosan, the polysaccharide which constitute the exoskeleton of insects, crustaceans, and cell wall of few fungi, are also great source of immunostimulants. Numerous research have reported the positive outcome of chitin and chitosan to improve protection against pathogenic bacterial infection. Vitamins, particularly vitamin C, is important micronutrients in fish feed. Besides its function in many physiological functions, it is also essential in regulating immune systems. Studies also found that increasing vitamin C significantly increased protection against Aeromonas hydrophila in Rohu. Besides what have been mentioned here, there are whole lots of other compounds that have been tested and produced great effect as immunostimulant for fish. The global interest towards immunostimulants over conventional antibiotics are increasing. And hopefully this is a great movement towards practicing sustainable aquaculture. Well, that's all for now. If you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Till then, thank you for watching and see you next time.